Okay, so when you actually have a piece of greenware that needs to dry, they must all dry before they actually go into the kiln. Butterflies, it's all dependent on the width of the product and the thickness of the product. So if you look at a butterfly, for instance, this probably only takes about 3 days to 4 days to dry. But it's all dependent. If you have really thick butterflies, then it may take 5 to 7 days. It's all dependent on how thick they are. So the goal is to keep them relatively thin, but not thin enough that they're going to break, right? So it's a little tricky. So you've got to think about the thickness of a product. So if you were doing something like this, which is a fifth grade product, you'll find that it's a little bit thicker, and so we would allow this guy to probably sit and dry for 10 days or less, maybe 7 to 10 days for this guy to dry out. Now, the thicker the product, you need to, dependent on, the good thing about this particular clay is very flexible, meaning that it doesn't crack if it dries fast. We're very fortunate to have this product. Some clays need to be covered up, so they slow dry, because if they dry too fast, they will crack. So if you're concerned that your piece is very thick, then go ahead and wrap it so it dries slower. But most of these projects that are in the curriculum are thin enough that they should dry without coverage. Unless for some reason someone made a monster and it's ridiculously thick, then go ahead and cover it, and it may take a lot longer to dry out. Just look at it when it's drying, and you can tell whether or not the product is dry or not. Okay, having said that, we're going to go into glazes so you can understand what you can use on your greenware. Now, this here is greenware. It means it's just been made, it is a wet piece of clay. The only product that you can use on this is a undercoat product. Now, it works on like very similar to stroke and coat in the sense that if it's a layering system, you let it dry, you layer it again, you let it dry, you layer it again for a deeper color. This particular product does not have any chemicals in it. So you could use our paint brushes, but it's very important that you rinse them out very carefully. Another thing is this product is designed to be put on the whole entire piece, including the bottom, but we have found from time to time it has stuck to the kiln shelf. Hence the reason why we now make sure every single piece of clay, whether it's greenware, bisque, or whatever, it always has the sponge. The volunteer parent will go ahead and sponge off the bottom and make sure that there is no glaze of any sort on the bottom of the product. So, and it needs to go up the side of it as well. So make sure that you get the edges, just around the edges too, when you sponge off the glaze, so it doesn't stick to the kiln shelf. Now, the kiln shelves are extremely expensive, and we want to preserve them as long as we can. So you, the volunteer, are responsible for making sure that there's nothing on the bottom of your products. Okay, so the next step is understanding the glazes. This particular glaze, you can use the paint brushes, like I said earlier. When you're using something like this, which is Jungle Gyms, which has these really fun colors like this, or Stroke and Coat, which is a lovely color as well, you need to use paint brushes that you'll find at the very top of the brush cupboard, which is the backup brushes and the Mod Podge brushes. And the reasoning why is because these products have flux in them, and they have a chemical in them that we do not want to mix with our paints. So you must use these particular brushes with these particular products. Now, one thing I did forget to mention was that the undercoat one, which you can use with all different types of brushes, is a matte finish. So if you do want a gloss finish with your undercoat product, then you have to take it to get fired. And once it's fired, it's in this bisque state, and it has this coating on top of it. You can go ahead and put a clear coat of glaze, which is a clear coat, over the top of it, and we can fire it once again. Another option is we can lacquer it and spray it and you're done. It's up to you what you decide to do. But most of the time we find with the kindergarten classes, we use the undercoat or we get it bisque fired and then we can acrylic paint it and then lacquer it with a spray. Any questions? Come and see us in the MIA room.